Iran security forces have arrested the main perpetrators of a failed drone attack on a military site in the central city of Isfahan. In a statement, Iran's intelligence services said investigations are continuing, but the role of Israeli mercenaries in the sabotage attempt have already been established. They added, failed operation was desperate response to crushing blows the Israeli regime has suffered inside occupied territories. However, intelligence services stress Israeli aggression will not remain unanswered and warn the regime of, quote, a lesson to remember. Late last month, Iran's defense ministry said that it had repelled a drone attack on one of its workshops in Isfahan. Attack did not cause any loss of life and only caused minor damage to the roofs, to the workshop's roof, that is. And now joining us from sunny Irvine, California, for more on the story is Professor Alexander Azadgan, academic and senior geopolitical advisor. Hello, Alexander, pleasure to check in back with you. It's been a while. Hope you're safe and doing well out there in Southern Cali. Alexander, my initial question to you, we saw just a couple weeks ago a balloon, a weather balloon, U.S. is calling it a spy balloon, just fly over U.S. territory. It did not cause any deaths. It did not cause any real destruction or damage until the U.S. government itself blew the thing out of the sky. It's the only time you saw an explosion. So why is the Israeli regime time and again, when it comes to people, they're killing people, hitting facilities inside of on Iranian soil with no UN mandate, with no permission from anyone except themselves, and they seem to get away with it, at least in the international arena, if it's not left up to Iran to avenge its sovereignty.
Good to be with you, Danny, as always, and our global audience. The collective West needs to evolve and grow out of the mindset that West's problem are world's problem, but the world's problems are not the West's problem. This goes with the fact that you mentioned about the Chinese spy balloon over our country, over the United States. What we do know about this incident when it comes to Iran is that operatives from both the intelligence agency as well as the IRGC intelligence agency were involved in this operation to catch the people who carried out the deed. Iran says the drones were assembled inside Iran, which the parts were smuggled into Iran from the Iraqi Kurdistan region, which is used as a safe haven by anti-Iran terrorists and secessionist groups. The anti-Iran groups usually operate from this area. They pass the most insurmountable area of Iran's northwest border in order to penetrate into Iran and do this evil deed. What I would advise Iranians is better media messaging, better information operation, more public diplomacy, and an enhancement in psychological operations, media warfare. We need to make sure this story is covered not just by our own, which is Press TV, but other news channels. We need to actively encourage that. There's no doubt, Danny, that Iran is involved in a shadow war with Israel. This manifests through proxy attacks, through cyber warfare, vis-a-vis industrial sabotage, and even residential high-rise buildings that collapsed in the past 6 months. And Anthony Blinken actually hinted to that, which I think was outrageous, absolutely outrageous. We do know that Netanyahu has a fixation and obsessive compulsion towards Iran. I don't believe in regime change. That's their sentence. Those are their phrases. I call it nefarious systematic destabilization, NSD. So the collective West strategy is to plunge independent nations like Iran into social, political, economic, and geopolitical crisis. The social parts of it we have all been following and seeing in the streets of Tehran. Ultimately, Danny, what they want is a comprehensive confrontation towards Iran. And what Iran wants is the destabilization of West Asia, of its Asian politics, and in essence, the de-Americanization. But what we are seeing right now is a reality check. What we need is, you know, what we need is in the West Asia is a reality check, because after Trump reneged from JCPOA, we are still stuck into this mentality of being able to negotiate with these countries. This was the past. We need to look into the present and the future and not give an inch. Western media's collective script is completely deceptive, in my opinion. It's a collection of fractured facts and collapse of meaning. Go ahead.
I didn't mean to cut you off, Alexander. We don't have a lot. We have about a minute left, but I really want to get this second question out to you. These attacks, I mean, we very well know, whether it's on people, the assassinations, whether it's on putting a hole in the side of a wall of a building, it's not going to put an end to Iran's nuclear program. It's not going to put an end to Iran's drone program, to any kind of, you know, naval facility, or, you know, I don't know. You basically get what I'm saying, to Iran's space program. What then is the point, Alexander? What do these attacks achieve?
Terror, and also they want to explain Iran. They want to portray Iran as unable to ward off against their attacks. Both Iran and Israel have read The Art of War by Sun Tzu, which states, if your enemy is superior, evade him, which is what Iran is doing. And from the Israeli perspective, if your enemy is weaker, take away his incentive to wage war. To me, it's absolutely outrageous when they go after residential buildings. I believe the Israelis had a hand in that. And to answer your question in 15 seconds, what they're trying to do is create doubt in the minds of the Iranians, put them in a state of terror that anything could happen, and that the Islamic Republic is responsible for this, not foreign entities. And nothing could be more false than this.
All right, bud, always a pleasure to check in with you. Do stay safe. From Irvine, California, Alexander Azadgan, academic and senior geopolitical advisor.